I love exploring ancient mathematics because the ancient mathematicians had to make decisions, had to work things out without the tools that we have today. So how did they do it? Well, the greatest of them all was Archimedes, and he found the volume of a sphere. How did he do it? Well, we think it may have gone like this. He produced a cylinder and a sphere and something called a double-napped cone. So there's the sphere, and the cylinder is the same width and the same height. He could have made them out of wood or clay, pottery, I don't know. But anyway, he had them made or made them himself. And this double-napped cone, which is two cones that meet in the middle. Once again, same width, same height. So he thought about this. He thought, if I take a line across the top of these, the cross-section of that equals the cross-section of that, plus zero at the North Pole here. Right. If I take a line halfway down, then the cross-section of that equals the cross-section of that, plus zero here. Does that mean that if I take any horizontal line through the three figures, then the cross-section of that will equal the cross-section of that plus the cross-section of that every single time? And he said, I bet it does. But how could he prove it? Simple. He dunked this in water, let it settle, and measured the level of the water. Took it out again. Dunked these two in the same water, and the water came up to exactly the same level. So the volume of that plus that equals the volume of that, QED. So what was that volume? Well, he knew that a cone was one third of the cylinder it would fit into. Just like a pyramid is one third of the cuboid that it would fit into. Get a pyramid, build the walls up, put a top on it, it's a third. And I can prove that because I've got three pyramids here. Can you see? Instead of the point being in the middle, it's on one corner. And because of that, you can actually reassemble them, these three identical pyramids, to make a cube. Which proves that each is one third of the volume of the cube. So if that is one third the volume of that, then that is two thirds the volume of that. Well, the cylinder end is pi r squared. And this is the same height as the same width. It's 2r down here.
Because it's two radiuses.
Two radiuses or a diameter. Pi r squared times 2r, which is 2 pi r cubed. So that is a third of it. So it's two thirds pi r cubed. So this must be twice that. 4 over 3 pi r cubed.
This episode has been supported by KiwiCo, redefining what it means to play with these fantastic crates that make everyone feel like an engineer or designer or, frankly, a bit of a genius. Today, I'm making an electric pencil sharpener. Everything I need is here, batteries are included. And this isn't just going to sharpen pencils, the build's really sharpening my critical thinking and problem-solving skills. It's just so satisfying seeing it all come together, and I really feel like I'm learning how it all works, how all the pieces combine. And with a lot of us spending a lot of time at home these days, what a great way to occupy the future geniuses in your household. You can see here all sorts of crates are available, delivered right to your door, and for 50% off your first one, go to kiwico.com/numberphile. There it is on the screen, kiwico.com/numberphile. Now I know you probably think these are mainly for kids and they're also a great gift, but I can vouch for the fact older kids love them as well. And there is one seriously sharp pencil.